Well, just to finish up now, Apple shares soared 7% overnight after it announced its suite of generative artificial intelligence features and products that will be part of forthcoming upgrades. Well, the view of analysts is the new features will spark customers to upgrade their iPhones rather than to hang on to previous models, which has been a feature of slowing Apple growth in the previous few years. The Apple iPhone 16 is due to be rolled out in September, along with the upgrade to the operating system, iOS 18. But there's another change here in Australia that's worth watching. Apple, alongside the ANZ Bank, will join the buy now, pay later industry. Effectively, when you pay for an item on your iPhone in future using Apple Pay, you'll be asked if you want to make four payments. In other words, buy now, pay later. The buy now, pay later contract, if you accept, will be financed by the ANZ Bank. Now, it's worth noting, the ANZ broke ranks with its rival Big Four banks back in 2016 and became the first bank to do a deal with Apple to offer Apple Pay. Prior to that, the big banks sought permission from the ACCC to act as a block to try and force a better deal out of Apple. Well, now the ANZ has effectively split ranks again with its rivals. It says, Apple this is, it's open to allowing other buy now, pay later companies, including Zip and Afterpay, onto its platform as well. But the big question is whether ANZ's boss, Shayne Elliott, will get the cold shoulder from fellow bankers at the next meeting of the Australian Banking Association Council. But with form like this, we reckon he kind of might be a bit used to it, let's say.